I think we're ready. I think we're ready.
We're good?
Yeah, I think so. I think so.
Oh, shit. You were filming that?
Yeah.
Oh, got it.
Yeah. We're at the Mecca.
The Mecca. The origin of the Hips Don't Lie Award, deep inside the heart of the beast.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I mean, the sign was there, but maybe you recognize this red bench. You recognize that red bench?
Every girl that has yoga pants is like,
Yeah.
Which is every girl.
And we're also doing the same thing. Yeah.
I mean, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this week's Bike Gang Report. Really, every Bike Gang Report.
Yeah.
Lululemon.
Lululemon.
Yeah.
That's why we're here today.
Without you, we wouldn't have Hips Don't Lie Award.
I would not.
And the world wouldn't be nearly as good a place.
I wouldn't show up that much. Like, I'm not showing up.
You're not showing up at all now. Damn, shots fired.
I'll be there.
Shots fired.
What have we got, man? It's been a while.
It's been
so long.
It hasn't been a while for me.
It's been so long.
Well,
but what people don't realize, that there's two biking reports floating out there that haven't been posted.
You're right.
There are two. There's some winners out there.
One's on your phone, right?
No longer on my phone. I needed space for Theophilus London and his new album. And it told me I didn't have enough
solid,
room.
Solid download. But wait, so you just deleted it?
I deleted it.
Wow.
Yo, old news, bro. Old news. Old news.
I thought you might have saved it one for the archives or something, but I guess not.
No. There's one from last week's Halloween party.
Right. It's a mystery who has it, though.
That's a gem. I know who has it. Keep it. Save that.
That bike gang report was a mess, though.
That was a good
one. This one's already so much better, more well put together.
Yeah, I think so.
That was a real hot mess.
What do we have for...
Let's talk about announcements first, and then maybe what happened this week. Let's look forward, and then we'll talk about what's going on.
Okay.
Announcements. We crushed 3014. Obliterated it.
Yes, you guys did.
Yeah. We could have had 3015. You know what I'm talking about. Whatever, man. We miss you as well. That's what I'm trying to say, man. We just miss you.
Thanks, man.
We almost had 4,000 people working
out.
That's
crazy.
That's nuts.
All at the same time.
Shoutouts to Brogan and Boyan.
They put it together,
man. Happy
birthday,
NP.
Yeah.
I think, on a slightly serious note, I think we're all really happy that NP exists.
Yeah, I am.
I really am, too.
I met some super cool people.
Who's that?
The list is forever. I mean...
Right, but you can't name one, probably.
I can.
Yeah?
Yes, I can. Pete Cruz. He reached out to me
today.
Shout out.
I should have seen that one coming.
No brainer. So what do we got? So
3014.
Did it.
Crushed it. This weekend, Berkeley Half. We were debating. We're pretty sure it's this weekend.
It is this weekend.
Okay.
It is this weekend, and I think there's like probably like 15 or 20 people running it from NP.
So
it's a team.
Good luck if you're running. If you're not running, we got cheer sections per usual.
Yeah.
Get yourself out there. Go crazy.
Yeah.
There's
a pasta party. There is a pasta party. And there's transportation from Civic Center.
Right.
Out there.
Tontek is, I heard he's going to segue over.
He's going to swim.
Oh, well.
He's going to segue to the water.
He's told us different things.
I can't believe that, dude.
Yeah. Awesome blog post from Tontek, by the way. If you haven't read it.
It's amazing.
Get yourself together.
Yeah.
So pasta party, brunch afterwards at the Dog Pound, courtesy of Amy. Well, everybody, but hosted by Amy.
Yeah.
Who's now a blogger, by the way.
I see that.
Like, prolific.
I see that.
Like, every day she's got an article.
I don't know how you type that much.
That's not for me.
Yo, my emails at work are like text messages to people, like three words, and I shorten everything. I can't imagine typing more.
I'm surprised that you're not using, like, a telegraph to send messages to people.
True.
Like, I feel like that would just be way more your style. Like, Morse code. You wouldn't even know what you were sending. You'd just be like, beep, 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 beep.
Figure
beep,
it out.
Just, like, pushing the button.
Figure it
just
out.
There's no clue what you're saying. That's way more your style.
We're Hills tomorrow.
Bernal.
That's my style.
That's your style.
Burn.
Are you going to be there?
No, but I work. You can see my job from, like, across. Like, when you're up top looking at, like, that
Maybe in the photo tomorrow when we get everybody together.
I could put it like a red arrow.
We'll all just like wave. That'll be the thing
yeah,
we did.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll see you. I won't see you, but it's beautiful. So yeah, yeah, show up there.
You'll probably see us. Look up, see a massive group of neon. Neon folks up there. This week.
Yes.
Awesome workout from Ian. Would you rather work out?
Did he have Bill Cosby involved? Did he throw Bill Cosby?
There were no Bill Cosby.
No Bill Cosby hickeys.
Which was a really big surprise. All the pundits predicted there would be Bill Cosby plastered all over that kind of workout.
Yeah, yeah.
If you would have been consulted, you would have had a lot of
Bill Cosby.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
But the best would you rather easily was would you rather have a vagina on your forehead or a row of penises down your back like a stegosaurus? What would you choose?
I would have to say the row of penises on my back. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
Would you wear like special fitted clothing for that? Or?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. Did you not see who had a hoodie like that? It was Kinley. But she was a dinosaur. But you get the idea. She had the thing going on.
Kinley,
that's what I would do.
Kinley, don't ever wear that penis hoodie in front of Jorge again. not a good look.
It was a dinosaur thing. It was beautiful. Her and her friend made
actually,
it.
I actually
it
do like, think I know what you're talking about.
And it went all the way down.
Right.
Imagine that with penises.
Not going to do that.
Game changer.
Not going to imagine that.
Game changer.
Katie Kunkel won the Positivity Award. So well deserved.
Who the fuck gave her that?
Laura.
She is mean, man. Katie is...
It's all a front. It's all a front.
Yeah, right?
It's like...
And I think Laura told her, hey, do me a favor, wear a pink shirt tomorrow. Make it look like, you know, you smile. I know Katie.
I feel like on the surface, she likes to do the get the fuck out of my face type of deal.
Yeah.
She probably really looks up to Meg.
Yeah.
But on the inside, it's just like, you can just get right past that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
she deserved it. I mean, like, did you know that actually Katie eats bowls of spaghetti through a straw?
I did not know that.
Yeah, through a straw. No hand. She doesn't even touch the straw with her hands. She just goes and gets up in there. Like, you know when you're, like, trying to get the straw, like, from your cup and you're not looking at it?
Yeah,
you're, like,
yeah.
You're trying to, like, find it. You're, like, you're talking to somebody.
Yeah, yeah.
She just does that with the bowl.
And just eats it all of it.
Yeah, right up in there.
Did you know that Katie doesn't drive a car?
One at a time. What does she do?
She pushes her car. I've seen her do that.
So she lets five people sit in it.
And pushes the car to the workouts if needed. I think she actually pushed her car to the airport to bring Polly to the airport to go back home.
I mean, she's fast enough to do it on the highway and wherever else.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just really considerate.
Yeah. Yeah, she is a nice person.
Why travel with five when you can travel with six?
No, she's not.
Congrats, Katie. You deserve it.
You deserve a bunch of grape jelly is what you deserve.
What else we got?
We got...
awards?
Yeah, why not? We're
rolling. We're live.
Rolling. It's
we're
like
live.
10 minutes
Those
to go.
Those guys are mean mugging us. Like, yeah, this is a
like
show.
What? Yeah, we're in front of Lululemon, dude.
Fucking show.
Go to the bar.
MVP. MVP this week.
No brainer.
Not even close.
No brainer.
Shannon Kimball. You warmed our souls with your story, touched our hearts, and then you went out and crushed a marathon and proved that you're physically more powerful than all of us.
Yeah, and what's crazy is that I heard, because Gretchen, like, they work together, like, some days, and, like, Shannon does not have a foot anymore. She left it in New York.
Right. She did the whole marathon with one foot, one peg leg.
Yeah. Finished it. Talked to Pete Cruz after.
Mm-hmm.
He hyped her up, and she left, and she's back here. And she's like, I don't think anyone noticed.
Yeah. I mean, she still ran really fast. Like, imagine if she had 2 feet, you know?
Insane.
Probably world record stuff right there. No. You deserve a champion. Congrats.
Hell yeah.
There you go. We're all proud. And thanks for sharing your story, too. What other awards do we have? Oh, Hips Don't Lie, obviously.
Hips Don't Lie. Hips Don't Lie.
I'm going to go ahead and say, this was election week also, we missed that, but you don't get a vote on this one because you probably forgot what Hips Don't Lie looks like.
It's not that I forgot. It's that in the last 2 weeks, maybe three weeks, someone posted a video from somewhere. I think it was New York. Had a girl walking down the street, and the first thing I'm like, if they didn't put a caption on it, I would have been like, yo, that girl is fly, right? That's what I would have said.
You would have said that to her?
I would have said that. I would have been one of those dudes on the street going like, whoa, what's up?
What's up, mommy?
Yeah, hey, my name is Jorge. But then I would have been one of those creepy guys.
Did you watch the video? Did you see that guy that walked with her for like 20 minutes?
No, I wouldn't have done
really
that.
Really weird.
No. That was a little awkward.
Yeah.
But now I'm thinking, I'm like sitting there, I'm like, man.
Like, action.
Part two.
Part three. This is part three.
This is part three.
We're definitely putting in part two as long as that like 3 seconds split exists.
We got this.
Finish strong.
Okay. All right.
Hips don't
give
lie.
Hips don't lie. Word.
Becky, you deserve it. We did leg throws this week. Blew my mind. Sorry, Rob. Congratulations, Rob.
Duh Cannon.
How are you still single?
Oh, who is it? Who does that? That goes to...
We talked about this.
Yes, we did. It goes to Lydia Chambers.
Lydia Chambers. Really, just an all-around type of woman.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. Never seen a more adorable penguin in my life.
Yeah. She was the sweetest.
Also, a couple weeks ago at the Coit Tower, Friday Hills, mm-hmm. She beelined to me when she was like, Zip, I made cookies this morning. You better eat some of them because they're delicious and you don't want to miss them. She was like, serious about it. You want to eat these cookies. And they were.
She brought me cookies, cookie dough for my birthday. Brought them to the house.
Wow.
And she brought me gummy soda things. So,
next
fellas, one. If you're watching this, like, why are you not?
Right.
Like, why are you...
Stop watching.
Why are you
pause.
Not?
Hit pause.
Why are you not?
Dial up the whole Facebook Messenger thing.
Mm-hmm. We thought about
it. I've lost track of what part we're on.
We were on... Well, let's just start. Let's just start from the beginning. You want to go on a boat.
You want to be on a boat.
You want to see the sunset
I'm
behind
on
the
a
bridge.
Boat and it's going fast.
Who do you call?
Who would you call? Nautical... You don't know that song?
Yes, I do.
All right. I can't believe we weren't singing along. It's a great song. I'm going to call Lydia is the answer to that
Lydia
question.
Chambers. You would call her.
I wish Lydia would call me. We should go on her boat.
That may be considered... I gotta watch that video again. But if you fell off that boat, who would save you?
Lydia.
Once she got you to shore, and let's say the ambulance... No, let's say you needed a call for help. Lydia would run. 8 miles, 9 miles, 10 miles.
To her scooter. Mm-hmm.
Go pick you up.
Little surprise there.
Bring you to the hospital... That is still under construction, but fortunately, she has the blueprints, and she knows how to get in into like the emergency room because she's fucking Lydia, and she knows how to do that stuff.
Amazing woman. You want to be, gentlemen? You want to be with a woman who has blueprints to a hospital? Look no further. Look no further. So the search is over.
And then when you think you can't get, like, you know, when you're sick and you're like, what the fuck am I going to do? I don't know. She's going to show up in a penguin outfit.
Make your day way better. Way better. She had some Facebook post that was like, showed up at work today. Something didn't feel right. # missing penguin.
See what I mean?
Like the week
after
Halloween.
See what I mean? How do you not want that in your life?
Yeah. Get on it, fellas.
Don't sleep.
Last award.
Yes.
Goes to one of the newest, most consistent shower uppers. Also a speed demon. Fast dude.
Please tell me.
The award is called the Astronaut Award.
Astronaut.
Because in the absence of some of the incumbents, we're going to say, you know, I'm basically comparing you and Andy and Patty and some of the more early fast folks.
Mm-hmm.
To the communists is essentially what I'm doing there.
Okay. All right.
And Jens is like sweeping in as the American who's now like on the moon planting the flag. Maybe it's a hoax. You know, you don't know if
you don't know.
On the moon.
Is that a real photo?
It's like, is he really that fast? Is it all in my head? What's going on?
But he's killing it.
He's killing it. So Jens, if you see this, please show up in an astronaut suit to Hills tomorrow. Thank you.